As much as you watch reminds me a lot of Eisen as he was talking about the planning and all that shit, even though he didn't say planning, but it sounded like that. It sounded like the plan begins. It sounded like that kind of stuff. But honestly, I believe that probably 50% of that was going to make more sense later on down the story. From the other half that I kind of gathered is that he was saying that everything that Ichigo has been doing has only happened because he's given the consent. Obviously, we know that Zangetsu is a part of Ichigo, and Zangetsu inside of him being Uarch has allowed him to use his powers. So in a nutshell, he has accepted everything that Ichigo is doing for his own cause. That's from what I can gather anyway. But then again, if you realise when Ichigo was talking to Uarch, he said he was neither him nor Ichigo at the same time. He was just in between. It's still very blurred, and that's what I like about it, because it's probably going to get explained later on down the story and a bit of foreshadowing in this chapter for something towards later on. But as much as it did sound like Aizen, it did have a different meaning to it compared to Aizen. Like, I planned you since you were born. Uarch is more like, everything you've done, I've allowed. Sounds similar, but completely two different things. That being said, Uarch brought up an awesome point of Ichigo saying that he really doesn't say he's going to kill his enemies. He's always said that he was going to stop his enemies, to which, you know, is quite true. I don't actually recall Ichigo saying that, but it does make me question why Ichigo's never said that. And the only possibility that I can come up with is Ichigo has never really been the person that he's always despised. He doesn't really want to belittle himself to be the same as an enemy, to kill people. He just wants to stop them and to protect what he wants. Sure, he can kill Hollows, but that's because Zanpakuto actually purifies souls and doesn't kill them like a Quincy's arrow does, for example. I could be talking out my ass, but it does make quite a bit of sense, don't you think? With Grimmjow, he never killed Grimmjow, and he was a bit distressed when Sonoratore had hit him with the sword. When he did his new move on Candace Catnip, and then after he fired that Getsuga, he thought that Candace would know that to dodge that shit because it was really going to injure her. So I generally don't think Ichigo likes the thought of killing someone. I believe that he just wants to stop them, which seems very plausible. But again, tell me your thoughts in the comment section down below about that stuff. But it was a nice little touch upon things, actually. It was nice to kind of go a bit more into Ichigo's character. So I like that about this chapter. Now I'm just going to go get my bitch fit out of the way. I mean, not that I expect anything of Ganju. I mean, Ganju, what? I don't expect him to do anything. He's just, well, what can he do, really? I mean, it'd be really surprising and over my expectation if Ganju actually fucking did something. But Chad's just sitting there, he's got popcorn at the ready, and he's watching this fight. He didn't even back up fucking Bay Yoruichi. And the person that he said he would always watch his back, Ichigo, at the start of the series, yeah, Ichigo, you got my back, I got yours. Where the fuck was that, bruh? Not that I expect anything of Chad either, because I've never really liked Chad as a character, but Jesus Christ, man, not a shout, nothing. I mean, shit, even Orihime did a bit of yelling. At least that was somewhat contributing to the fight. But I'm glad Kubo's letting Yudawichi do a few things, because Yudawichi is a character, she's a badass bitch, and I like to see her do badass bitch things, even though we know that what she is at the moment stands no chance against Uarch, but she is making a difference. She is trying to do things while Ichigo's keeping Uarch sorted, like, you know, putting a barrier with a Soul King and trying to slow down Uarch, even if it's for a second. But with them bombs, it's a nuisance, and it, you know, even if it stops Uarch for a second, it helps everything matters. And also trying to give Ichigo that morale boost, as Uarch was telling him the whole thing about what he's allowed Ichigo to do, and Yoruichi kind of saying, you know, shut the fuck up, don't listen to him, Ichigo, you know. So I mean, through Ichigo's support at the moment, the rest of them are fucking useless, and Yoruichi seems to be the only one that's actually doing anything. But at the end of the day, plain and simple, Orihime could have put up a shield to back up Yoruichi. I hope that she does go to heal Yoruichi's arm, because if she doesn't, I'm going to be like, Orihime, what's your purpose on being there? As much as I love you, girl, you know, you got to make yourself useful. Chad, just punch her in the fucking face. Do something. Try. At least try. And then I won't bitch next time. And Ganju, I mean, you get the audience pass. You can just chill and watch, man. I mean, fuck it. You're probably going to die if you do something anyway. You might as well just sit back and enjoy. And you watch physically grabbing Mimihagi and ripping him off the Soul King. That's pretty fucking ballsy. I mean, I don't see what the point is. I mean, once the Soul Society, the Soul Palace, Waygo Mundo, Earth's gone, like, what's your whole point? You're going to be living in complete nothingness. Is that what you want? Nothing to rule? Nothing to conquer? Just complete nothingness? I mean, he's got hell. I mean, he could probably go hell. I don't think that affects hell, so Maybe. And before people say, you know, if Mimihagi dies, what's going to happen to Ukitake? Ukitake is pretty much dead at this point. I'd be surprised if Kubo can kind of twist it around. But, I mean, at this moment, Ukitake is a vessel. And as soon as Ukitake's body gives in, that leaves him and Mimihagi both dead. So, I mean, the survival rating for fucking Ukitake right now is very slim. Very, very, very slim, in fact. And it is kind of a little nice thing to see that Uobox team of elite guys is still around and kicking, and they're somewhat not making themselves fodder, and they're still kind of making themselves relevant. It's still interesting to see what that guy, I believe it's the compulsory, to know what his technique actually is, because always seeing him is like twist things, but what's the difference with that compared to the wind? Damn you, Yoruichi, you took this chapter like a champ. I mean, an arrow to the shoulder and then your arm twisted? Man, I'd be fucking screaming if that shit happened to me. But still, tell me your thoughts in the comment section down below, guys. Here's the comments from last week. Very fairly quite awesome chapter, as per weekly. You know, I love my Bleach. Had my things with Chad and Ganji, but again, I never expected anything of them anyway. And I believe that this was very good potential foreshadowing in this chapter. And of course, Uryu versus Ichigo, I can see it happening. But then again, the unfortunate thing is in Bleach with the whole Uryu and Ichigo thing is that we know that Uryu kind of isn't a bad guy here. We know that his intention is not to stay with your watch. And I think because the majority of us know this, it kind of takes away that shock value every time Uryu does something. So if Kubo can make it a bit more convincing that maybe, you know, Uryu, yeah, he is definitely an enemy at this point, then, you know, it's going to feel like, well, not surprising and not exciting for Uryu's character. But then again, I'm hyped to see what he can do and what Uwatch has given him in power-wise. But with that being said, I'll catch you motherfuckers out. You guys, of course, is fine. They have been Hansened. Spread the news about that Bleach greatness. Will we get Aizen Summer next chapter? Who knows? Fuck it, I'm ending this video. I'll catch you motherfuckers later. Peace out.